Well, I'm on my way out to the blind, and I've had her sitting there for a couple days, so these prairie dogs should be used to the ground blind. Now, as you look around here, you can see that the alfalfa is just being hammered by these prairie dogs. And the farmers don't like them, obviously, because it costs them a lot of money, and cows break their legs in them, horses do, makes it rough on the vehicles. It's just a nightmare these prairie dogs create for farming. And what happens is the farmers will come in with poison. They'll blanket the whole area, either with a plane or with their tractor. They'll poison grain, and then it'll kill all the prairie dogs. Or they'll let a guy like me come and hunt the edges of the prairie dog town and help keep them contained. Most guys shoot them with a high-powered rifle. Today we'll do it with a bow. Should be fun, so come on, let's go see if we can kill some prairie dogs. So we got prairie dogs all around us. Most of them are out of range. They're about 60 yards out there. I'm trying to get a nice close shot. I'd like to shoot one with the blow gun, but we'll take them with the bow if we can. I had one right here in front of me. He keeps popping. Oh, here he comes out. First one of the day, first shot, took him right off the top of his hole. And the others, they're still sticking their heads up. They have no clue. I put my double bolt blind up out here. Now there's prairie dogs coming up all around it. I got 20 arrows. Let's see if I can get some prairie dogs. Got him. Bingo. Ran a slocker right through the middle of him. Let's do now. Okay. Boom. Slocked him at 55 yards. Prairie dog hunting's fun, but I've discovered a great way to hunt him now, and it's called a ground blind. I don't know why I've never tried this before. I always snuck up on him and shot him, but this is pretty cool. I put the blind down a while back and a few hours ago, and they're already used to it coming out. I just shot that prairie dog out there a little over 50 yards, made a beautiful shot on him, and the old slocker flipped him upside down and dropped him right there, right off the edge of his hole. Not sure if I got him or not. It looked good, but might have been a little bit to the right of him. As soon as the arrow leaves the bow, they're starting to go down. I'm making the mistake of holding right on them. I'm going to start aiming a little lower. That way the arrow goes through the dirt right under their feet. By the time they're going in the hole, it'll take them out.
Now, I'm not always patient enough. For if you give them time, eventually they will come completely out of their holes. And when you do, you got a full body shot.
Slocked him good. Another one bites the dust. He shouldn't have came out of his hole.
Now, when they're sticking their head out of their hole and that's about it, you better hold low, because they're fast. They can usually duck out of the way.
Bingo. This is crazy. I'm slocking these critters one after another.
Okay, so first hour of the hunt has been good.
I recovered three out of the five, but discovered a new process that I hadn't seen here with the what do they call them, prairie dogs, and they have a tendency to pull your arrow and go in the hole. So you need a backhoe to dig them out, or you lose your arrow sometime. But anyhow, I got three fat ones, and that one there's a young one, probably a year old, and then two great big ones. I'm going to have to clean them before it gets too hot.
Stick with me, for when we return, I'll stretch them out a bit.
This next spot is close to the barn down here. There's more prairie dogs here than anywhere I've ever been in my life. They stretch for miles. They make these homes, they call them a town, prairie dog towns. And they may be 2 square miles of nothing but prairie dogs. You drive on down the road, go another mile, there's another big town. It's crazy. I'm sure the bunny huggers want to hug them and make us stop shooting at them, but man is a hunter. He has been a hunter since the beginning of mankind. And now we've come to a point where it's almost weird. People think that we should stop hunting. Yeah, it's crazy. Spirit of Bear this year in Alberta. And it was like the whole world lost their mind. Like hunters hunting animals, you want the animals to get away, you should be wishing me luck that I can get spear hunting legal everywhere, because it's hard and the animals get away. But once in a while you get lucky. Anyway, what was I thinking? Oh, we're gonna go shoot a prairie dog down by the barn, so come on.
I got two of them, side by side, about 120 yards down there. Here we go. Tell me when, Jimmy.
Yeah.
All right, watch this arrow drop in there. Lay them guys right on the bottom of the screen. Arrow's gonna drop from about 6 feet to 6.5 feet above. Here we go. Oh, just a little bit over his head.
I can hear old Sasslips over there, and he's warning all the other dogs that something dangerous is in the area.
There's another one out here, 70 yards. He's standing up big time. Here we go.
What was that? Did you see that, Louie? Something buzzed right by my head.
Got him. There's one right in front of him to the right. Got him.
Yep.
Is he still there?
Yep.
Is he by a little green stick or something?
Yep.
Okay, I see.
Sometimes they'll stay low and peek through the grass at you.
Got him. That's a pretty good distance for a prairie dog. It's about the limit there, 70 yards. I missed him the first shot. Ripped him open good the second. I got one arrow left, and there's a prairie dog out there at 120 yards. I'm gonna try him.
And
from the very beginning.